Dawson will always see me as, you know, the gawky little girl down the creek.
I've known you forever, but I feel like I'm seeing you for the first time tonight.
Dawson, you've had a lifetime to process your feelings for me. And I can't spend the rest of mine hoping that you might throw a general glance in my direction.
I love you.
Our lives have always been so intertwined that in many ways I feel like you partially invented me, Dawson. And that scares me so much. I need to find out if I'm capable of being a whole person without you. I may have lived across the creek, but it was only when I was rowing in this direction that I actually felt like I was rowing home. Everything between you and me is so complicated.
You can't have both of us. You can't have him as your boyfriend and me as your consolation prize. You're going to have to make a choice.
After everything that's happened, how could I possibly climb that ladder into your bedroom?
But I was selfish, and I didn't want you to go. I wanted you to stay here with me. And this time, you have to go. You have to see for yourself, all right? I can stand here and tell you that it's a colossal mistake and that all roads lead back to me, but that's not going to make any bit of difference.
Dawson.
Joey, go. I'm telling you before I yank it all back.
I still hear you. No matter how much we yell or no matter how quiet you are, I hear you, Dawson.
I hear you too, Joey.
It's gonna be weird, isn't it?
What?
Next year, I mean, me in Boston, you in Los Angeles.
All timeless, life-altering moment.
A couple years ago, in this room, I was standing over there by the window, and you kissed me. I want you to stay.
But it's time to go. It's time for me to get out of this room. It's time for you to discover who you are without us. This chapter's over, Joe.
I know that there's a part of me that's gonna be in love with you for the rest of my life, but you know, this running in place and this daydreaming, it's just not healthy for either of us, and so this is me cutting the cord.
Joey, it hurts to be around you. I see you beaming from across the room. That brings up a thousand memories, not just of us, but of my entire life before. It's like I'm frozen in this place that I can't bear to be. I care about you so much. As long as I can remember, everything's always come back to you.
Why'd you come all the way to Florida?
I went down to Florida to tell you that I love you.
Sorry, Dawson. And if we really mean to each other what we say we mean to each other, then there's nothing to worry about. Everything will work itself out, I guarantee you. I want the fantasy. I want more than anything for us to be together.
If we can't argue like this and get past it, then
maybe there's nothing here worth saving. And sometimes the hardest things to say are the things that really matter.
Why do you think I've spent years trying to write an entire screenplay about you? Doesn't matter who ends up with who. If in some unearthly way, it's always going to be you and me.
So
all we have goes beyond friendship, beyond lovers. It's forever.
I love you, Dawson.
I love you too, Joey.
You know me always.